A drunk 16-year-old girl at a party, raped by two high school football players. It was an outrageous case that shocked the entire country and forever tarnished the name of the town in which the heinous act occurred, Steubenville, Ohio. Especially after images of the attack and about the attack went viral.
Greetings, citizens of the world.
Many of us first learned of the rape after this guy got involved, this masked man threatening revenge on the whole team of high school football players wearing that Guy Fawkes mask, the international symbol of the hacker group Anonymous. His wrath was centered on not only those two young men who were sentenced to juvenile detention after being convicted of rape in March, Trent Mays and Malik Richmond, both of whom may soon be moved to a residential rehabilitation center with a program for sex offenders. No, Anonymous was also focused on the other players and students who'd allegedly documented the assault, who'd laughed about it and did nothing to stop it. Hackers compromised the team's fan website. Anonymous demanded the players apologize to the victim, and if they did not, their personal information would be shared with the world.
This docs will be released unless all accused parties come forward by...
When the apologies didn't come, the masked man published this video.
And she wasn't moving.
That clip of another student at another party laughing about the attack went viral.
They peed on her. That's how you...
Ultimately, 2,000 people ended up rallying on the steps of the Steubenville courthouse, demanding justice in what became not just an outpouring of support for the Steubenville victim, but opposition to the cultural problem of rape. The man behind the mask we now know is Derek Lawstutter, formerly known online by the handle KY Anonymous, a 26-year-old corporate cybersecurity consultant and aspiring rapper who performs under the name Shadow.
I hear him talking about me, man.
Lawstutter outed himself to the website Gawker after his Kentucky home was raided by the FBI, which was searching for evidence that he had hacked into the team's booster page. Lawstutter says he had nothing to do with the hackings, that he only posted the videos. Lawstutter says he's now facing 3 felony counts, including taking control of a secure computer and identity theft. And some media outlets like Think Progress are outraged that if convicted of hacking, Lawstutter could potentially face more jail time than the rapists. Sentencing guidelines are a bit more complex than that headline would suggest, but this all feeds into this meme of injustice, of a society that goes after the wrong people.
Relatives and phone numbers is being compiled as you watch.
But is it that simple? Not everyone thinks the Anonymous community universally acted heroically. False accusations have defamed innocent people, propelled wild and insane conspiracy theories, and in the view of some in law enforcement, complicated the investigation.